This is the world's hottest pepper. The Carolina Reaper is more than 400 times spicier than a jalapeno pepper, and it's so hot it could cause thunderclap headaches,
a medical issue that could lead to hospitalization.
But why and how are people even able to eat this?
We're talking to a hot chili specialist to learn more about spicy food and to understand how some people can handle the heat
while my body can barely stand it.
Chili peppers have different flavors depending on what family they're in. Some have sort of a dusty, dry flavor, like a cayenne would be a good example that everybody's familiar with. Other chilies like habaneros or scotch bonnets are in a family that's very tropical fruit flavored. They tend to be a little bit hotter. So they can add a lot of flavor. They also have a stimulating effect on certain receptors in your tongue. Actually, you have them all over your body, which is why your fingers might burn, or if you rub your face might burn.
Originating in South America, chili peppers have been grown to flavor food, fumigate homes, and treat illnesses for 6,000 years. There are 25 known wild species and over 50,000 variants, with each pepper giving off a different set of flavors and levels of heat. Before Columbus sailed the ocean blue in 1492, peppers were pretty much unknown to the rest of the world. Today they are eaten worldwide and are a dominant ingredient in lots of cuisines.
The difference between a chili pepper that's very, very hot and one that isn't is the level of a chemical known as capsaicin. And that is concentrated in the ribs of the chili. A lot of people think the seeds are the hottest part, but actually it's in the ribs, and the seeds are attached to the ribs, so they pick the heat up just by contact. The more capsaicin you have, the hotter the chili will be.
When capsaicin enters your mouth, it excites pain receptors called TRPV1. Which are linked to the sensation of temperature. So that coughing, burning mouth, runny nose feeling that you get when you eat something that's too hot, that's your body's natural reaction to thinking your mouth is on fire. The more peppers you eat, the more heat you will be able to tolerate over time. When eaten regularly, capsaicin depletes substance P, a neurotransmitter responsible for sending pain signals to the brain.
You know, there's this thing, oh, I can eat the hottest pepper, I'm so macho, but you've probably been eating them for a long time, so your receptor is not able to transmit the messages of pain quite as well. In Mexico, they actually give children lollipops and candy that have chili peppers in them to sensitize them, or I should say desensitize them, to the capsaicin and the chili pepper, and you work your way up. And the interesting thing is that if you stop eating them, and this has happened to me where I might not eat any for a while for whatever reason, I pretty much have to start over. A chili that really wouldn't have bothered me anymore, or in the past now, is very, very, very hot.
Ready for your fun fact? When you eat hot peppers, capsaicin causes the brain to release dopamine and endorphins, giving you a sense of euphoria similar to runner's high. This could also lead pepper lovers to crave the taste more and even be disappointed when their meal is not spicy. The spiciness of peppers is governed by what is called Scoville Units. The scale was created by pharmacist Wilbur Scoville, and its levels are generally related to the capsaicin content of each pepper. The chart ranges from 0 to over 16 million, with peppers stopping at 3 million. Bell peppers are at the bottom, chipotle, jalapeno, and tabasco are in the middle, and towards the top, we have ghost pepper and the Carolina Reaper. Capsaicin can even be used in surgery to numb pain. When placed on wounds, capsaicin destroys neurotransmitters that send messages of pain to the brain. Doctors are even trying to develop epidurals that use capsaicin so women won't have to be confined to the bed during childbirth. Needless to say, with all these benefits, eating hot peppers can still temporarily harm you, especially if you're not accustomed to the heat. They can cause stomach pain, flu-like symptoms, and those thunderclap headaches I mentioned earlier. If you're trying to get into spicy food, approach with caution. Luckily, our friend Bill has some tips.
They're hotter at the stem end because you have the membrane is much thicker at the stem end than down at the bottom. So maybe a good way to start eating is to go down and start the bottom, or cut the outside of the chili, you'll get more flavor, avoid the ribs. I would just start low on that 1 to 10 scale. I would not start at the very top because A, you could hurt yourself. B, you might never want to eat a chili pepper again. I mean, there are chili peppers now that are 3,500,000 1,000 plus heat units used for medicine.
If you eat something too hot, don't worry. Drink milk, not water, as water-based liquids will only spread the oily capsaicin to areas of your mouth that it didn't reach yet. Milk contains a protein named casein that attracts capsaicin molecules, wraps around them, and then washes them away. But that's only milk that comes from mammals, so if you're into plant-based stuff like soy, coconut, or almond, chances are they won't do much for you.
It's interesting that you find typical Mexican cuisine is typically served with crema, which is a creme fraiche, kind of their version of our sour cream, and there's a lot of cheese on things also. So yes, the Spanish brought the cheese to Mexico, and anybody would embrace cheese who could get their hands on cheese, but I don't think it's coincidence that we have crema served on many things and we have cheese served on many things. So it is a fact, scientifically.
Well, I got my milk and my Carolina Reaper. Let's eat. Hey guys, thanks for watching this week's episode of What the Facts. Hope you enjoyed. If you did, make sure you hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Got a weird body science question? Shoot your shot, drop a comment below, and who knows, we might cover it. Be sure to catch more of this season every Tuesday.